everybody. I bet you're wondering why I have a bunch of blue Tupperware containers. Today I'm going to show you kind of a small guide to feeding isopods and springtails and kind of the general like update on these cultures as is. So let's start with the springtails since they are the easiest. And I got my two newer cultures. As you can see, it's kind of moving around, but their food source is kind of depleted. They eat the mold off white rice. Yeah, I know. Weird, right? So what I do is take a bunch of white rice. You can also feed them yeast. Brewer's yeast. They love that. I just put a bunch of white rice in there. You don't actually need as much as that. But I want to skyrocket this guy, and I give it a good solid misting to make that... make them, rice particles to grow some mold. Sorry for all the crazy voice. And then here is the next culture. It's still kind of growing. It's still new, but they've definitely went from a pinch of guys to way more. And culturing does take some time. It's not immediately, but if you plan a year in advance or so, you'll have enough cultures of these to be in great shape for practically a lifetime. So you can always create more. Simple, done, isopods, or springtails, not isopods. And I just have a little baggie of rice. It exploded on me, so now I have it in a tiny container, but that's about it. I'm experimenting with different things to feed the isopods though. Got a little cup of cat food here, a little bit of shrimp formula, another shrimp formula. They are a type of crustacean, so hopefully they like one of these three things. But let's take a look at this culture. You can see a lot of little poops everywhere, so they're definitely roaming. And there's one right there. These are the zebra. Autofocus. Dang it. Picture of them. Boop. Yeah, you can see there's a little bit of springtails hiding in here too. And they've been eating on that carrot for a while, but I'm going to try some new food for these guys. And I'm also going to add a little more leaf litter in there. So I'm just going to take a couple pinches of cat food, some really stinky shrimp food, and bottom feeder food. If I can. Darn autofocus, turn back on. There we go. Remember to open up your containers. And these are kind of in like little pellets like rabbit food. I'm just going to throw a couple of those in, see what they like the most. And, we'll probably try a little bit of the ZooMed stuff, but. I gotta set you guys down. Can't unscrew tops one handed. So this is a little smaller pellets. Well, let's add that in there. They seem to be doing pretty okay in general. These guys do take a little longer to reproduce. My autofocus keeps coming off. But, they're doing really good, I think. So, they still have a while to go before we're going to start getting a lot of little babies, but for right now, oh yeah, I probably should mist them a little bit. My Monday misting. I gotta keep it a little damp. These ones like them a little drier than the other species. But damp enough like you would expect to find underneath a log or a stump somewhere. That's what they like. So we'll close that one off. And we'll go to the next culture. I have no idea which ones are which. Oh yeah, I was gonna add a little more leaf litter into that one, so hold up. So I'm not sure when it stopped recording, guys, so hopefully I will see that in post, but I'm going to dig through here, and there you guys go, giant. These guys have grown a lot. These are the giant canyon isopods here, and he's just gone. So I'm going to add a tiny bit more leaf litter, like the latch batch. Hopefully you guys saw that, otherwise I'm going to film that another day or something. A little bit of leaf litter. Just a little bit more in there, those little oak leaves. And then I'm going to add a tiny bit of both food sources down into that corner there. A little bit of you, a little bit of cat food, and hopefully they like some of that. I haven't found a good food for them yet. And then just the good misting. These guys are growing pretty big. They get really big, so these ones are good for, like, if you don't want them getting eaten by dart frogs or, you know, even geckos and stuff. These guys are quite a bit bigger, so they should last a little bit longer in a tank. They'll still have their babies eaten, but not nearly as bad as, like, the white ones, which are coming up next. Just in case you guys did not see the last culture and I somehow missed my recording, there in here was a big group of them all huddled up on a branch for the temperate ones, so I really hope I got that. Looks like my recorder's running out of time here, so let's open this next bin, and we'll stop us there. And we're back! My phone has more memory, so let's take a look at these white isopods in here. I've seeded all of my vivariums with these guys so far, and I think they're doing pretty good. They like to burrow quite a bit. There you guys go. Some tiny little white ones. There are some babies that are mixed with springtails. Like, this is kind of how the culture ends up going. Look at them all. They're just everywhere. They don't get terribly big, which is kind of cool. But these are the dwarf white isopods. They just fill up your dirt. These will actually end up being food for dart frogs sometimes, so keep that in mind. They seem to have not touched the carrots so much, so I'm not going to put any more carrots in these guys. But I will. I'm adding a little more leaf litter for all these cultures. I think they deserve a little more hiding spots. And I'm just going to put a couple more pinches of food here and there. Trying out these different shrimp foods, lobster foods. Put a little cat food in there. And missed it like the rest. And there you guys have it. This is pretty much the simple kind of like feeding care guide I do for these guys. There's not much to it. You just feed them once in a while, miss them once in a while. Just keep them happy. You don't have to work too hard though. They're not like chomping at the bit. But if you want them to reproduce quicker, more food. But then you have to deal with mold more. So you gotta kind of balance it between the two. I've seen all the culture of these guys, so I'm sure you guys kind of know how to do that now. And if you haven't, I do have a video on culturing isopods, and I set up two of these cultures on that channel, or on that video. So there you guys go, the different little culturing options and feeding options for isopods. So I will keep you guys informed in the future on how these cultures are doing, but so far, so good. And I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching, and you guys know what to do. And this is Bleakborn. Have a nice day.